O Lord, who enlightenest all created things in the light of thy wonders, and knowest the intent of every man before it is formed, and strengthens those who desire to serve thee, do thou the same, Lord, now array in thy fair and spotless vesture these thy servants, Soren and Dimitri, who desire to become taper bearers before the holy mysteries, that they may be illumined, and that, attending unto the age to come, they may receive the incorruptible crown of life, and rejoice with thine elect in bliss everlasting. For blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Sorry, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I just bless you, Lord.
So that the leader is tortured. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. O Lord God Almighty, elect these thy servants, Soren and Dimitri, and sanctify them, enable them with all wisdom and understanding to exercise the study and reading of thy divine words, preserving them in blamelessness of life, through the mercies and bounties and love toward mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed together with thine all-holy, good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
God, who is rich in mercy because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in transgressions, made us live together with the Christ. By grace have ye been saved, and raised us up together, and made us sit together in the heavenlies in Christ Jesus, that he might show forth himself in the ages which are coming, the surpassing wealth of his grace and kindness upon us in Christ Jesus. For by grace are ye saved through faith, and this not for yourself, of yourselves. The gift is of God, not of the works, lest that anyone should boast. For we are his work, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared for him in order to.
That's what I thought.
On the other side of the bed.
So, you need someone?
Не есть бы муж от жены, но жена от мужа. Ибо не создан бысь муж жены ради, но жена мужа ради. Сего ради должна есть жена, власть иметь и на главе, ангел ради. А бачи не муж без жены, ни жена без мужа, Господи. Яко же бы жена от мужа, сица и муж с женою, вся же от Бога. В вас самих судите, лепо ли есть жене откровенней Богу молитесь, или не самое естество учит вы, яко муж убащи в лосы растит, бесчестие ему есть. Жена же аще в лосы растит, слава ей есть. За нерастение власов вместо одеяния дано быть ей. Аще ли кто мнится, спор ли в быти, мы такового обычая не имамы. Ниже церкви Божия.
My sons, the first degree of the priesthood is that of reader. Therefore, it behooves you to peruse the scriptures daily, so that the hearers regarding you may receive edification, and that you, without in any way shaming your election, may prepare yourselves for a higher degree. For by a chaste, holy, and upright life, you shall gain the favor of the God of loving kindness, and shall render yourselves worthy of a greater ministry, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom be glory unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Blessed is the Lord. Lo, the servants of God, Soren and Dimitri, have become readers of the Most Holy Church of the Theotokos Joy of Canada Church, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Достоин.
Thank you, Honorable Deacon, for Archbishop Blasen and Bishop Harlan, for the Honorable Priest and the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, for all civil authorities, and for the Canadian Armed Forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick, the suffering, and captives in their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Memory of the most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the birth giver of God and ever virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Pecioara Maria cu toți Sfinții Sobovanim, pe vincine și univiații și toată viața noastră, lui Hristos Dumnezeu să vă dăm.
Ție, Doamne!
Virgin who is ineffably in this latter times conceive and give birth unto thine own Creator,
save them that magnify thee. Wisdom, let us attend.
Господи,
come let us worship and honor before Christ, O Son of God, who revived from the dead, save us, return to thee. Alleluia. The angel was led by two, and the guards became a dead.
Establish this vineyard which your right hand has planted. Seigneur, Seigneur, regarde du haut des cieux, vois, visite, et affermis cette vigne que ta main droite a plantée. Ô Gospodi, Gospodi, prisris nebesie, vis posseti ut verdi vena grazie, jego žena sadi, desnica tvoja.
Glory to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and up to ages of ages.
Given on in six stone, O Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
O Lord, save thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O Lord, my God, thou wast magnified exceedingly. Christ and minister of sin, may it not be lives in me, and the life that I now live in the flesh I live in faith, in that of the Son of God.
Come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For anyone who would save his life will lose it, but anyone who loses his life for my sake and the sake of the gospel shall save it. For what does it profit a man if he gains the whole world, but suffers the loss of his own soul? For whoever is ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him will the Son of Man also be ashamed when he comes with his angels in the glory of the Father. And he said to them, truly I tell you, there are some of those standing here who shall not taste death till they have seen the kingdom of God coming in glory.
Sunday after the cross, and by God's mercy we can bless the new Kreuze in the garden today as our offering. And I want to notice also the small marble cross on the stone, which is in memory of everybody who perished under the Ustasha in the Second World War, all the Serbs, because the cross came from Serbia. And today we hear again that if we take up our cross and follow after our Lord Jesus Christ, we can enter the heavenly kingdom. But those who try to turn away and avoid the difficulties that come with striving to live a life in Christ and to live according to the gospel wander away from the light and back into the darkness once more. Remember that the cross is the tree of life that grew in paradise. For the two trees in the Garden of Eden were surely a type of the Holy Cross. And when we saw the two thieves crucified on either side of our Lord Jesus Christ, the one thief who recognized Christ as the good and understood the fullness of his own evil, the cross of Jesus Christ became the tree of the knowledge of good and evil for him. And when he said, Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom, the cross of Christ became the tree of life for him. For the tree of life grows in our midst constantly in our Lord Jesus Christ is the fruit of the tree of life, the living bread that came down from heaven, the bread of life that we received in the Holy Communion. But today the communion chalice is the tree of life, and the fruit of the tree of life is our Lord Jesus Christ himself. But what is it to take up our cross and follow after him? It's not simply that we should provoke suffering or have to suffer in order to follow our Lord Jesus Christ. Sometimes when we strive to suffer for the sake of the cross or our Lord Jesus Christ, all we do is fall into delusion and become prideful and arrogant about ourselves. But to have a life in Christ, to follow after the cross, to glorify our Lord Jesus Christ in the midst of the world, isn't done just with words. One can always repeat mantras, praise the Lord, glory to God, and these things. But that's not testifying of our Lord Jesus Christ, that's testifying of ourselves. For unless we live a life in Christ, unless we live a life that has some transformation, inner transformation, into the image of our Lord Jesus Christ, our proclamations are in vain. Our words are written on the wind. Unless there's something in our lives that projects some kind of genuine love for mankind, that projects an openness and an understanding and a constant forgiveness, and a constant seeking of forgiveness. There's no reason why people should believe any words that we speak. But so many people preach and scream the name of Jesus Christ, but their lives, their arrogance and hatred and malice, testify of Satan and not of Christ. But let it not be so amongst us, but having heard the words in the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us be transformed into the image of that love which stretched forth its arms upon the cross to embrace all of mankind. That image of that Christ who suffered far more spiritually and morally in the Garden of Gethsemane, when he took upon himself the burdens of humanity and wept blood over the condition of mankind. So great was his suffering and torment at the condition of mankind that he asked that the chalice be removed from him. And yet he showed solidarity with the lowest and the meanest of humanity by being crucified. The death sentence of the lowest and the meanest of humanity. If our Lord Jesus Christ identified himself with those who were outside and outcast, with those who were despised by humanity, how can we imitate our Lord Jesus Christ unless we show solidarity with the same? I believe in my heart that the greatest sin that we commit is the sin of judging and condemning another person, because we can never see their heart, we can never see into their mind. We can never see the suffering and the grief of their lives. We can never see what weighs upon them and pushes them down. We can never see what torments have brought them to the condition they're in. So we cannot judge even just judgment, let alone righteous judgment. But all things have been placed under the feet of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ in judgment. Is his and his alone, because he only can see into the depths of the heart and the mind and the spirit and the soul and the history of each individual. But our Lord Jesus Christ judges only with compassion and mercy. For he said, I will have mercy and not sacrifice. Today, as we venerate the cross in the garden, when we bless the cross, and seeing Christus Vayomo again, let us worship, brother, what the cross stands for and what it teaches us. And let us see that the cross is a dividing line between light and darkness, so in our Lord Jesus Christ, separates light from darkness and seeks to separate light from darkness in the heart of each of us and in the world around us. The cross itself is the boundary and the border between light and darkness. And truly, it's the tree of life which grew in paradise. And we, by God's mercy and grace, partake of the fruit of the tree of life in Holy Communion. Let us approach the chalice as also the cross. With fear and trembling, not fear or terror, but awe-stricken by the great, unselfish and co-suffering love of God for mankind, that the cross itself symbolizes, that the cross itself testifies to, that the cross itself preaches to us day by day. Brothers and sisters, let us rejoice today in the cross of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, and looking upon the cross, cry out from our heart, Lord, remember me when thou comest in thy kingdom.
Amen. Our soul and with all our might, let us sing.
The Lord have mercy.
O Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hear, hearken, and have mercy.
The Lord have mercy.
For His Eminence Archbishop Lazar and His Grace Bishop Arlam, may the Lord God remember in His kingdom for all metropolitans, archbishops, bishops, and for all the priestly orders. May the Lord God remember them in His kingdom always, now, and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
The sick and suffering servants of God, among the first, the handmaiden of God, Zinaida, Mikhail, Petra, Elena, and all of our who should have to pray.
May the Lord our God remember in his kingdom all his power and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. The servants of God who have been gathered unto the Lord in the hope of the resurrection to life everlasting, all for whom we've been asked to pray, may the Lord our God remember in his kingdom always and now and ever and unto ages of ages. All you pious and orthodox Christians, may the Lord our God remember in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. May the Lord God remember your high priest in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Spirit. Of our holy and God-bearing fathers amongst the saints, the great hierarchs and universal teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, Dr. Chrysostom, Athanasi the Kyrill, and John the Almsgiver, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas, Archbishop of Mira, Italy, Kiel, Spiridon, Bishop of Trinipon, the wonder worker of the holy righteousness, Carius of Pentapolis, and of our holy and God-bearing Father Andrew, the Metropolitan of Kiev, whose memory we keep, of our holy and God-bearing mothers amongst the saints, Macrina the Younger, Irina Chrysovalamto, the holy wonder-working and mercenary physicians and healers, Zenaida, Philadella, and Hermione, of our holy mothers of Egypt, Mary, Thais, and Sarah, and St. Pelagia the Repentant, and St. Hilda of Britain, and of the holy Theopatiris, Joachim, and Anna, and of all the saints, whose memory we celebrate today, for he is a good and merciful and man-befriending God. Procession to bless the new Tritha cross in the garden. I want to, everybody knows Vladik Irine, of course, but what people don't know is that he's a very old and dear friend to us that we've known since 1972 or so. And we were classmates together in the seminary. And it's always a joy to have him here as the ruling bishop of Canada, but it's also wonderful to have him here as a beloved friend. So we want to welcome him especially today, and thank you for the joy that he's here with us.
But Vladika beat me to it. I was going to just say before that he sang that it was just recently Vladika's name day, and it's the name day for several people. Think for yesterday was it? So all the Sophias and Vieras and Nadezhdas, please step up forward, okay? And don't be bashful, come. Because I know there are Nadezhdas here, and at least one bed or two. Okay, a prosperous and peaceful life, rich in blessing and joy, health and salvation, success in all things. Grant, O Lord, to thy servants, the Archbishop Irinae, the handmaidens of God, Sophia, Vera, Nadezhda, Ilyubov, and to their servants, Vlad and Doina, and all who have been here to help with the adornment of the church, and grant them many years.
God grant you many years. God grant you many years. God grant you many years.
everything he said is probably what I would have said, wanted to say, but he said it much better. He has a gift for speaking. Many of us, we don't really realize that the difference between the life we live as a Christian and the life that people who do not have Christ live. And these people who do not live with Christ, they have the same pains, the same illnesses, the same sufferings, the same losses as we do. How come for us it is salvation and for others it isn't? And it is simply the fact that we offer everything to Christ. We heard a few words, these words in the liturgy, and let us give ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. That is the key that makes a difference. And Vladika was mentioning the tree of life. The tree of life can be for also not for salvation. We have two thieves who were crucified with our Lord Jesus Christ. One of them offered himself up to Christ and confessed his faith, and it was for his salvation. The other one, who suffered the exact same sufferings as Christ, he was not saved. It is the fact that we offer ourselves and offer each other and pray for each other and support each other and carry our crosses together with Christ. This is what makes the big difference. It is very fitting today that we will go and bless this Troitsa, this cross, and it is very nice to build crosses and to put them up and to venerate them, but we also must carry the crosses in our hearts. May this little message that I'm giving you never forget that what we do makes it, if we do it, if we carry it, if we offer it to Christ, it is transfigured, it becomes life, whatever we do in our lives.
Christians
are the adversaries, and by the power of thy cross do thou preserve thy cause. As he goes by
of the all Holy Spirit and the sprinkling of this holy water in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
As we go back into the church.
And we want to thank you, Vladika, for blessing this cross for us, because it'll be here, God willing, for many years. And as people come to church each morning, they will be able to see the cross and be able to venerate it. And I, in case you weren't aware, I do want to say that this man out here, Vlad, is the one with his wife. This beautiful cross and their son too, and the family, so that everybody could come to it, to worship it.
Say, oh.